Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video I will explain how online test app is working and how its code is executing. Because I got lots of comment on this video to explain the code of online test app, so now I am going to explain it. Okay, let's get started. So first I will take the clone of this code. If you have installed Git in your system, then you can use this URL to get the clone of the code. Otherwise, you can directly download the zip file. After downloading this zip file, go to folder and extract this file here. Now open it and go to our main class, that is online test. So this is our online test. Now I will go to my Eclipse and here I will create one project, and in this project I will paste the code. So here need to define a project name, online test application, and here in this class, in this project, I will create one package, new package, that is com.gainjava.knowledge, and in this package I will paste this class, that is online test. So I will copy it from here and paste it here. So here we can see this is our online test app code. So first I will show you how this app is working. So first I will execute this code and run as Java application, then you can see how this app works. So this is question number one, which of the following is not introduced with Java 8? So here you can add any number of multiple choice question, and here I have added two buttons on this frame, and this frame is a J frame. And these are two buttons, and these are also four buttons, but these are radio buttons, and these are the labels where I have added the question. So here we need to select the answer. So here I have selected option one, and if I will select option number third, then first one will automatically deselect. So here I am using radio buttons and also using button group class for this, that I will show you in code. And after selecting the answer, now I will click on next, and now I am not sure about answer of this question, then I can bookmark this question, so we can check it later. So like this, I will select third one and next, 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 worst, next, like this we can select any answer. And if you want to bookmarks any other question, then we can also bookmarks. So here I will bookmark second other question, that is ninth question number nine. So bookmark two will be saved here, that we can see here if I will bookmark. And if we have bookmarked the question, then we can check it later, but before submitting the result we need to check. So here I will click on attached. So if I will click on bookmark one, then it will go directly to the question that we have bookmarked. So we have bookmarked question number second, so we will direct here. So now we can select the option and click on next. So it will not work. We also need to go bookmark 2, and here we can see session factory is thread safe object, so it is a true. And now if I will click on the result button here, then it will show one pop-up button and we can see result in our pop-up screen. So here we can see correct answer is 7, and it was the result or output. So now we will understand this application at code level. So here we can see this is our Java class. It is only single class. We have not write more classes for this. And this is the entry point for this class, that is the main method. So when I will run this as Java application, first our main method will be called by JVM. After that we will create online test object, and when we will create the object, this constructor will execute. And when this constructor will execute, the frame will be created. So here we can see we have not added any dependency, extra dependency or jar files to make this project. It is just by using simple core Java. And here for GUI level, we are using swing package, that is javax.swing package we are using, and we have created JFrame with the help of javax.swing. And we are also using here java.awt library because we are using action listener here. So if we will perform any action, then action listener will handle these all actions by using this method that we have overridden, that is action performed. So when we will perform any action, this function will execute. So here when the main method will execute, it will directly goes to constructor. And inside constructor, what we have did here, we have defined label. So label, when we will call this add function and pass label as a parameter, then only we can see it on the JFrame. Like this, we have created button group class object. And button group class object, why we are using here? Because we are adding these radio buttons inside our button group class. Means if we have selected only one option, then all other option will be non-select. So we are using here button group class. So here we can also read by just going on button group class. So here you can read, this class is used to create a multiple exclusion scope for a set of buttons. Creating a set of buttons with the same button group object means that turning on one of those buttons turn off all other buttons in the group. So here we are using. And next we have created next button by using JButton class. And here we have created second button, bookmarks. So we can see here when we will run this application, we can see these are the four radio buttons and these are the label value and these are two buttons, next and bookmark. We can add multiple more button also. We can also add previous button here if you want to go back. And next, what we did here, here we have added this button on JFrame. So we are calling add function. If I will comment this function, then we cannot see our next button on the JFrame screen. So now I will run this application and we will see next button will not be on the screen. So here only bookmark button is available and next button is not available here because we have commented this function. So when I will uncomment, now we can see next button also on the screen. So here we can see next button also and bookmark button also. So after adding these buttons on JFrame, here we have created set function, and set function will be called and all questions will be set. So this is user defined function, and here we have defined question number 1, and these are four options: radio button 0, radio button 1, radio button 2, radio button 3, and these are the value of radio button 0, 1, 2, 3 that we can see on GUI. So here we can see radio button 0 stream API, radio button 1 serialization and splitter, and fourth one is lambda expression, and this is the label value that we have set, label dot set text, and this is a question that we can see here, which of the following is not included with Javaite. Like this we can check next question, and this is a question number 2, but here it is current is equal to 1 because it is starting from 0 index. And label dot set text, and this is a question number 2, which feature of Java 7 allows to not explicitly close IO resource, and these are the four options that we can match. So like this we can add any number of questions like 20, 30, 40 we can add on this J frame. And next thing that we need to check here, after adding these questions on J frame screen, here we have set the boundaries for labels like this. This is a label. So if you want to increase the size of labels, then what we need to do here, we need to do changes, because label dot set bounds have four parameters. First one is x coordinate, and second one is y coordinate, and third one is used for width, and fourth one is used for height. If we want to define height for the component, then we need to change here. So here we can check this one. Our button next have boundaries like this, x coordinate 0. X coordinate is like this is our screen and its x coordinate and its y coordinate, and this is the height for our button. If I want to change the width or height, like if I want to change the height, make it 50, 60, then we can see the changes. Now what we will see change here, the height will be increased. It will be like this up to this. So height will be increased if I will do some changes here. So here I have increased the height of the button. Now I will run it again, and here we can see now the height of the button is increased. So I will make it same like bookmark button, so it will also be 30. So now I will run this again. So here we can see now the height is same as bookmarks button. So these are the main four coordinates, four parameters that will decide the boundaries for our button. First is x coordinate, second is y coordinate, and third is the width, and fourth one is the height of the button. And here we have defined set default close operation JFrame exit on close. If I will click on cancel button, then our JFrame will be closed. And here we have set layout as a null, and the location that we can see here, location will be automatically decided that we have defined here. Based on this location, this will produced. And here if I will define set visible alphas, it will not be on screen, so it must be true. And here we have defined size is 600 and 350. So this is the width and the height of screen. And if I want to increase the width of the screen, then I will change here. Now I will run this again. So here we can see the height of the application, our online test app will increase. So now we can see its height is more. So according to our requirement, we can provide any height to our screen or JFrame. So here I will make it 350 again, and we'll run this again. So here now our screen is like a small screen. And these are the action performed function that will handle all the actions that performed by next button or bookmark button. So because we have added button next action listener on this button, and we have also set the action listener on next button. And if I will click on next button, then our request will goes to here, and it will check if we have clicked button next. And button next, then it will check if this condition will be checked first, and it will goes and match the answer if we have selected correct radio buttons. And these are the answers of all questions that we have defined. So its first question, radio button 1 is the right answer, and for second question, radio button 2 is the right answer. So we can change it question, so like this. So here we have defined four parameter. Count is equal to 0, and count is defined because we will count the result, how many numbers of questions are right. So it will used for to count the number of right answer. And next one is questions, how many questions we have defined. And थर्ड वन इज एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन. सो वेन वी बुक मार्क्स दिस क्वेश्चन सो इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम वन. एंड वाई इज ऑल्सो वेन वी अनसर्ट द बुक मार्क क्वेश्चन इट विल ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट बाई वाई. एंड नाउ विल बी द करंट ऑप्शन दैट वी हैव सेलेक्टेड फ्रॉम बुक मार्क्स. एंड नाउ इफ वी क्लिक ऑन द नेक्स्ट बटन देन रिक्वेस्ट विल बी गोज फर्स्ट टू दिस फंक्शन एंड देन वी विल गेट सोर्स ई डॉट गेट सोर्स इफ इट इज नेक्स्ट बटन. देन फर्स्ट इट विल चेक इफ वी हैव सेलेक्टेड राइट आंसर और रॉन्ग आंसर. इफ इट इज राइट आंसर देन इट विल इंक्रीज द काउंट वैल्यू बिकॉज काउंट इज यूज टू गेट करेक्ट नंबर ऑफ आंसर्स. सो अवर आंसर्स काउंट विल बी रिजल्ट काउंट विल बी वन एंड देन क्वेश्चन विल बी प्लस प्लस नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एंड देन अगेन सेट फंक्शन विल बी कॉल्ड टू डिस्प्ले द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एंड वेन वी विल रीच अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 देन आवर बुक मार्क्स बटन टेक्स्ट वैल्यू विल बी चेंज एंड इट विल बी रिजल्ट वेन वी विल रीच अप टू 9th क्वेश्चन. एंड बटन नेक्स्ट विल बी इनेबल्ड एज फॉल्स सो इट विल ऑल्सो बी डिसेबल. नेक्स्ट बटन विल नॉट वर्क वेन वी विल रीच अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. एंड सो वी कैन चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर रिक्वायरमेंट. इफ वी हैव मल्टीपल क्वेश्चन लाइक 20 देन वी कैन चेंज हियर लाइक 19. एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इफ वी हैव सिलेक्टेड द बुक मार्क बटन फ्रॉम हियर ऑन स्क्रीन देन द रिक्वेस्ट फर्स्ट विल गोज हियर इन टू एक्शन परफॉर्म फंक्शन एंड देन वी विल गेट इट्स एक्शन कमांड. एक्शन कमांड मीन्स द टेक्स्ट वैल्यू दैट वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड हियर. दिस इज द एक्शन कमांड वैल्यू बुक मार्क्स. इफ इट विल मैच देन इट विल एड द क्वेश्चन एज ए बुक मार्क एंड वी कैन सी दिस क्वेश्चन हेयर ऑन राइट हैंड साइड इन द जे फ्रेम. एंड दिस इज द बाउंड्रीज दैट वी हैव डिफाइंड फॉर आवर बुक मार्क्स बटन दैट आर सेविंग हेयर. सो दीज आर द बाउंड्रीज फॉर दिस बटन. And after that, we have added this button into our JFrame. So we need to call add function. And then we have set the action listener also for this button. For this button, we have also set the action listener. And here we are using M. It is the array. And for this, we have defined the size 10 because we have only 10 questions in this test. So here M is an array and we have defined the maximum size of this array is 10 because we have 10 questions in this test. And x plus plus, as we know, it will use to define the value that we are seeing here, that is 1. It's a x value. And like this, set is used to display the question. And if question number equal to 9, then it will change the bookmark button value as a result. And here we have defined set visible false true. And like this for loop will be iterate and it will when we will click on bookmarks button it will check periodically and it will also check the answer of the question. If it is correct answer then it will increase the count value and the question will be now and then it will save the m of y value into question and it will show the question on display. That is JFrame. And after that we have clicked on bookmark button, this button will be disabled like this. If I have clicked on this, now this is disabled, we cannot again click on this button. If I will true, then it will not disable. So like this. And if I have clicked on result button, then it will first it will check the answer of the question, that is last question, and will increase the count if answer is right, and question will be plus plus, and it will show message dialog where we can see the result, and result is the count value, how many answers are correct. So correct answers count will be show on pop-up, and these are our questions. And these are the answers for each question. So this was all about our online test app. If you not able to understand anything, then you can ask any question in comment section. I will answer all question. Okay, thanks for watching this video.